Savior, groan that we might live. He is the gift. Hope and joy.
Good evening, everyone.
Good
evening. How's everyone doing this Christmas Eve?
Great.
Last year, I know where I wasn't here. So for all of you who are here for the first time, so am I. For all of you who have been here many times before, it's like the first time for me, so welcome. It is great to be able to gather together on this Christmas Eve. Last year, there was a snowstorm where I was. I think there may have been freezing rain or some other fun and excitement. And today, this year, we get to join together, coming together as a community to celebrate the birth of Christ. So as we gather together, a few things. There is a coloring sheet and word search at the back by the plant. If anyone's interested in those, you're more than welcome to come and get them. Also, this is a family service, so we have kids. I have a kid in my arms. There will be a little bit of noise, but there will also be the joy of Christmas, the joy of God's love, and possibly me talking too much. So as we gather together, as we just remember that we are joining together with multiple generations, with love and joy, and a guy who talks too much. So welcome as we gather for worship tonight. I invite us to join together as we sing, if I get this right, all right, call to worship. I knew I missed something. Call to worship. It's a responsive call to worship. I will be the leader, and if you'd respond with the lines that are marked with as people. Let us come together as friends and family to celebrate. We come to celebrate the birth of Jesus and God's love for all peoples and all of creation. We come sharing the gifts that God has given to us. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come tonight as witnesses to your goodness and love. We come to remember the night that you came from heaven above, entrusting a young couple with the gift that has changed our world. In the busyness of our lives, and the realities of struggle all around us. We pause to praise you. We know that all the craziness around us cannot overcome your love for your people. We remember how even wars were paused to declare your holiness to all who would hear. Gracious God, as we finish our journey of Advent and arrive at the stable in Bethlehem, help us to not lose sight of the giver of the gifts of the lessons we have learned. Help us to hold on to all that is precious and important as we come to the most important gift of Christmas, you and your love for all of us. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. I invite us to join together as we sing Hope is a Star. It's not it. Have journeyed through Advent the last 4 weeks. We, as part of the service, relight the Advent candles. Each candle reminds us of a gift of God and a promise from God. Tonight we will be reading through some of the Advent liturgy that we did each Sunday, and it's reminding us of God's gifts. Also, as we worship tonight, may this service be a gift to you. If you'd like to leave an offering, there is an offering plate just outside that door there, but we are quite happy to have each and every one of you here. So as we continue to journey through Advent, as we remember the journey that we've come to so far, and hand it over to Peyton and Raven.
The prophets called and we have seen to announce that hope has come from God.
Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down so that the mountains would quake at your presence. We shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
So, Reagan, how about you light one of the candles? Turn it.
The prophet called and the apostle writes that peace comes from God.
For a child has been born for us, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, and there shall be endless peace. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Jesus Christ.
The prophets call and the apostle writes to announce that joy comes from God.
The Spirit of God is upon me and has sent me to bring good news to the
oppressed,
to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captive, to confront all those who mourn, and to give them a
garland
instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning. Rejoice in the Lord always, again I will say rejoice.
The prophets call and the prophets sing to announce that God is love.
For the mountains may depart and the hills may be moved, but my steadfast love shall never depart from you in my
covenant
of peace shall not be removed. It is the Lord who has compassion on you. Give thanks to the Lord, who is good. Give thanks to the Lord, the Lord, who is steadfast love and nourish ever.
Thank you.
wait on his side in the peaceful quiet night. Wait with the shepherds so startled with fright. Wait on his side and gaze at the star. So
thank you very much, choir, for the blessing of your music tonight. As we continue to journey towards Bethlehem, I invite us to join our voices together as we sing, "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear."
Thank you.
So as we begin to look at Scripture once again, each of the Scriptures that we have is either a prophecy that leads to the Bethlehem stable, or the retelling of the Christmas story from the Gospel of Luke. Let us come before the Lord in prayer. Let us pray. Lord of understanding, help us to hear your promises and see your faithful actions. May your words and actions show us the depth of your faithfulness to your people, both long ago and today. We pray this in the loving name of Jesus. Amen. Our first reading comes from Micah, chapter 5, verses 2 to 4. And I welcome Phyllis, who will lead us in its reading.
But you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth.
Amen. The prophet Micah was pointing to that little town so long ago. The prophet Micah gave a message to the people that was fulfilled that Christmas Eve. I invite us to join together as we sing, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Silent stars go by.
The Christmas story begins in Luke chapter 2. Luke is one of the four Gospels that we can find in the New Testament. Luke retells that first Christmas night where, well, I don't want to spoil the story. Thanks be to God. We hear about different people who are part of the Christmas story. The shepherds that watched over their flocks by night were on a lonely hillside when angels came out. So as we continue to journey through the Christmas story, I invite us to join together singing While Shepherds Watched.
Watch their flocks by night, all seated on the ground.
Tonight's reading comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 15. I'd like to invite Heather to lead us in the reading.
Reading from Luke 2, 8 to 15. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
I invite us to join together as we sing "Angels from the Realms of Glory." The Christmas story. And I'd like to invite Craig to read from Luke chapter 2, verses 16 to 20.
"Please forgive me, people. I am not used to staying in front of everybody." Luke chapter 2, 16 to 20. "So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph, and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it was amazed at what the shepherd had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherd returned, glorifying and praising God with all the things they have heard and seen, which were just they have, sorry, which were just as they were have been told.
Thank you very much. I invite us to join our voices together as we sing, What Child Is This?
Changing gift God has given us. For
The beauty of Christmas is that for us, it comes after the shortest day of the year. This means that it was the day with the least amount of light possible, or least amount of possible sunlight, and the most darkness. Now, here's a question for you. Who here is or has ever been afraid of the dark? I used to be afraid of the dark quite nicely. I needed a light on at night or I would not go to sleep. Do you know that?
Yeah.
I thought so. Sometimes when we think of the darkness, or of darkness, we also think of the problems that people are facing. Light reminds us of hope, but darkness reminds us of times when we struggle. The birth of Jesus, well, very special, is only part of why Jesus is important, or why Jesus is important. Jesus' birth was the fulfillment of promises that God had made hundreds of years earlier. That is important in itself, but that is only part of why Jesus' birth is important to us today. Jesus was born into a time when there was a military occupation of the land. Another country was dictating what was going to happen. We can turn on the news and hear that that is very present in some parts of the world. We even find out that the political leader that was in place at that time was willing to hurt his own people to save himself. He was willing to hurt children to protect what he wants and what he desired. The leader at that time was worried about himself and not his own people. There are a lot of struggles and problems that Mary and Joseph and the rest of the people had to deal with at that very time. Jesus was being born into a place of struggle, a place of darkness, but also a place of hope. He was a light that shone darkness into that hope. But this itself isn't the importance of Jesus' birth. We like hearing about lights shining in the sky and angel choruses singing out over the plains. That is the reality that Jesus, or singing out over the plains, the reality is that Jesus was born into a messy place, at a messy time, where there were people who hated other people. Unfortunately, it's that we can find that in our own communities. Jesus was born into a time where people were willing to hurt and steal. Again, all too familiar to us today. Lie and cheat to get what they wanted. There were people that were cast out from families and friends to live on their own without any support for someone or someone to love them. There were also people who pretty much had everything going for them. But there was just a little something missing. The birth that happened roughly 2,000 years ago, give or take a decade or two. Reminds us of the need for Christ's light and Christ's love in our lives. When we light the Christ candle, that light is for those who are living with sickness, those with broken relationships, those who are living in fear, those who are struggling to make enough money to pay the bills, but seem to be falling behind. Those who don't quite fit in, and for those that seem to have everything going for them, but still need that love of Jesus in their lives. The light that Jesus brings into the world, his world, and we are his people, whom he loves very much, is for all of us. It doesn't matter our backgrounds, our bank accounts, it doesn't matter our social standing, it doesn't matter our toy collection, how vast or how small it is. It doesn't matter our address or where we live or who we know. It doesn't matter of our accomplishments. We are all made in the image of God, and we are precious in his sight. Psalm 72:14 reminds us, he will redeem them from oppression and violence, for their lives are precious to him. Jesus came because we are precious to him. And when we think about the manger itself, the manger, who here was born in a manger? Who here's parents have asked, do you live in a barn? You have very good parents. You're that or someone's lying. And you're all very clean.
Yeah?
Yeah? You keep your room clean too? Meh. The manger itself, when we think about God's light, it isn't necessarily the brightest place. I remember growing up on a farm and lying underneath where the cattle eat. So in other words, there's a good chance that the cow slobbered on me.
Yeah.
Ew. But you know what? Who's able to go into a barn? Or would you be able to go into a barn? Yes. Would I be able to go into a barn? Would wise men be able to go to a barn? Would angels? Would shepherds? Would someone as big as you be able to go into a barn? Yeah. Everybody is able to go to the manger. The manger isn't protected by guards or high walls. The manger is a place where the lowest person can go, or the richest. The manger is a place where Christ's light can shine for all people, for all those who need that light, for all those people who are struggling. They don't have to get a pass or permission. They can go to the manger. They can find Christ. They don't have to pass through big gates. They can go and be with the Christ child, who God entrusted to Mary and Joseph, who God entrusted to all humanity, so that Christ's light can shine even in the darkest places, even in the places that we struggle, in our brokenness, our hurting, our sicknesses, and even in the times when we are overjoyed with gladness, Christ's light can shine there too. When we think about all the things that God has blessed us with, the blessing of his love, of his light, of his hope, of his peace, of his forgiveness, can all be accessed in the manger. So as we come to Christmas, as we come to give thanks, as we come to worship, may we remember and receive the light of Christ, the forgiveness of God, and his eternal love for all humankind. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the blessing that you have given us. Lord, we thank you for the light that shines in the darkness. Lord, we thank you for the fulfilled promises that have come, that have been granted, that remind us of your continued faithfulness throughout all time. Lord, help us to not be overcome with the busyness. Help us to not forget about you. Help us to not be so busy that we don't have room in our lives for you to come and rest, for you to come and live. Lord, we pray that as we celebrate Christmas, that we keep you front and center, that we allow your light to shine in us and through us, and that we share your love with others. Lord, we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. At this time, I invite us to light the Christ candle.
The angels sing the glory of God in the highest heavens.
Be not afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth among those whom God favors.
At Christmas, God speaks in signs. The baby in the manger is a sign of a new life and new governance shining in the world. Christ is born and the world is filled with the promise of hope, signs of peace, joy, and the incarnation of God's love.
Holy are you, source of all new life among us.
Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
We join with all creation in joyful praise.
We light this candle because God has given me flesh and dwells among us.
As we take the time to light the candles, I invite us to turn on as we do so. May we say to each other and to those next to us, the light of Christ shines for you.
The story has been told time and time again. A story that has survived through the ages and continues to be a story of love, of grace, of God's infinite mercy placed upon his treasured creation, you and me. And though the story has been repeated year after year, it still brings a heartfelt joy and peace that angels proclaimed that night to wide-eyed shepherds. We too still stand in wonder and awe, as those wise men did in the presence of the King. The people of Israel had long awaited the Messiah. Would the prophecy be fulfilled in the expected ways? Or would God reveal his plan through unexpected means? Mary, chosen as the vessel to bring this baby of love into our world. Joseph, not fully understanding, but still trusting that it would be as God had said. Could they even fathom the impact this holy child would have? Not only in their lives, but also in countless generations to come? As Mary and Joseph looked into the eyes of their newborn son, they saw hope, they saw life, and they saw love. Assured that God was behind it all, and working his will in their lives for the redemption of the world. On that day, when Jesus entered in, it was truly a defining moment in the history of humankind. He came into this world, Son of God and Son of Man, a human being, human, and yet God, the prophecy and promise fulfilled at last. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light. Radiant beams from his holy face with the dawn of redeeming grace. It's still a story that renews us and and reaffirms in our hearts that God truly is with us, Emmanuel. And because he has come to us and reached out with arms of grace, we truly can live, love, and as the song says, sleep in heavenly peace. He wants to embrace our lives every day of the year. We're reminded every Christmas of God's passionate desire to touch our human hearts with his infinite love. And so, the story never ends, never stops moving us, never stops changing us. It's still the story of God's love.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank everyone for joining us tonight to celebrate the birth of Christ. As we go from this place, may we go with the glorious light of heaven guiding our way to the living love of Jesus born this day. May we go in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. It has been an honor and a privilege to be able to join together for this Christmas Eve service. May God's blessing go with you tonight. And before we go, is there goodies?
Yes.
There's a few goodies just on the other side of that wall there. If you go out those doors and go in that way, there's some goodies and then
apple cider.
And hot apple cider also. So everyone is invited to join for that. May God's blessing be with you and guide you on your way. Amen.